Franklin D. Roosevelt describes the four freedoms.
The first is freedom of speech and expression everywhere in the world. The second is freedom of every person to worship God in his own way everywhere in the world. The third is freedom from want everywhere in the world. The fourth is freedom from fear anywhere in the world.
But with victory, Winston Churchill warned of danger from the east.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent.
Sometimes oratory comes in a fit of humor. Fiorello H. LaGuardia, mayor of New York, reads the comic strips.
Now, children,
here's Dick Tracy.
He's been a detective so long. And he still has that slender form. Lou Valentine, why do our detectives get fat, I wonder? Let's see what Dick Tracy is doing. Now, get this picture. Here is wet wash. The doors of the laundry wagon are open. He's leaning with his back toward the wagon. And he's counting his money. And crash! He crashes it on his head. Knocked out. And say, children, what does it all mean? It means that dirty money never brings any luck.
Victory did not solve the problem of the atom bomb. Bernard Baruch proposes a plan to the United Nations.
We are here to make a choice between the quick and the dead.
1948. Many said it was time for a change in American politics. But Harry S. Truman made a successful prediction.
Senator Barkley and I'll win this election and make these Republicans like it. Don't you forget that.
The United Nations forces in Korea were led by General Douglas MacArthur. He had a dispute with the president, Harry S. Truman, and was relieved of his command. MacArthur spoke to the Congress April 19, 1951.
I am closing my 52 years of military service, but I still remember the refrain of one of the most popular barrack ballads of that day, which proclaimed most proudly that old soldiers never die. They just fade away.
Sometimes the loser in a national election also leaves his mark in the memory of those who heard him. Adlai E. Stevenson, twice defeated Democratic nominee for President of the United States.
Let's talk sense to the American people. Let's tell them the truth, that there are no gains without pains, that we are now on the eve of great decisions, not easy decisions, like resistance when you're attacked, but a long, patient, costly struggle which alone can assure triumph over the great enemies of man, war, poverty, and tyranny, and the assaults upon human dignity, which are the most grievous consequences of each.